Now let's understand each type of weld joint in detail. First of all, lap joint. Let's look at 5 common type of lap joint examples. So here you can see example of lap joint along with the weld symbol. Fillet weld lap joint. So fillet weld means connection between two surfaces. It's just like plate on plate or beam on beam, as you can see in this picture. Lap joint flare V groove. Flare V groove means weld between radius to radius or curved surface to another curved surface. For example, you are welding one tube to another tube or one pipe to another pipe. Lap joint bevel groove. Bevel groove means weld between flat surface and chamfered surface, or on the other word, one surface is flat as it is and the other surface is prepared with some angle. Lap joint J groove. J groove means welding between radius and the flat surface. Lap joint plug and slot weld. Plug or slot welding is fill out the plug or slot with the welding on the lap joint. Now let's see some examples of T joint with weld symbols. First, fillet weld. In fillet weld, one flat surface is making 90 degree connection with another flat surface, and make sure they are both touching with each other and that connection is available to weld on both sides. Then bevel groove T joint. Bevel groove T joint is the connection between flat surface and prepared chamfer surface with 90 degree connection. Flare bevel T-joint means connection between two perpendicular surfaces. One is flat and the other one is having radius. And similar to flare bevel, J-groove means one surface is flat and the other one is having radius and they both are making 90 degree connection. And in this case, radius is inward opposite to the flare bevel. And finally, square groove T joint. Square groove T joint is connection between two flat surfaces at 90 degree connection. But in this case, these two metals are making connection with each other, but not physically touching each other. Now let's see some examples of corner joint. The important thing about corner joint is it's different from T joint, because T joint you can weld on both sides. But corner joint is only on one side. So it's a perpendicular connection, but it's not possible to weld both sides of that perpendicular connection. First of all, fillet weld corner joint. As you can see, both surfaces are matting each other only at the corner. Then second, bevel groove corner joint. Same with fillet weld, but in this case, one surface is prepared with some angle. Third, flare bevel groove corner joint. Just like fillet weld and bevel groove, same connection, only one surface is having radius and the other one is flat. Now fourth is edge joint. Edge joint is connection between two edges. So faces are not matching with each other, but in this case only edges are matching with each other. First, flare V groove edge joint. Here you can see two radiuses are touching each other. Second, bevel groove edge joint. As you can see, two ends of the chamfer are touching each other. And third, V groove edge joint, where both surfaces are matching each other and both surfaces are prepared for edge joint. Remember, there is no fillet weld possible for the edge joint. And final one is butt joint. Butt joint is very common in piping industry when you need to join one pipe with the another pipe or one tube with the another tube. Similarly, in construction industry when you need to splice two columns or you need to splice two beams, butt joint is common. Remember, in butt joint, two metals are not touching each other or they are only touching each other partially. First of all, bevel groove butt joint. As you can see, one surface is flat and the other one is having angle, and weld metal is filled in between those two. Second, flare bevel groove butt joint. One surface is having radius and it is prepared, and the other one is flat. Flare V groove butt joint. Both surfaces are prepared and both radiuses are making flare V groove connection. Fourth, J groove butt joint. One surface is flat and the other one is having radius opposite to flare bevel groove. Fifth example is square groove butt joint. As you can see, both surfaces are flat and they are touching or not touching each other, which will make square groove butt joint connection. Sixth, U groove butt joint. As you can see, both surfaces are prepared and they are making capital U. Seventh, V groove butt joint. V groove butt joint, both surfaces are prepared and they are making V connection, and weld metal is filled in between those two metals. Now let's try to learn some useful terms. First, T, Y and K connection. So as you can see in this figure, some members are making T, Y or K connection. They are part of corner joint or T joint. Here you can see the example. It is mostly used in truss or structure frame connection. CJP and PJP butt joint. CJP means complete joint penetration and PJP means partial joint penetration. This is a common term used in a butt joint, and whenever there are two metals in butt joint not touching each other, it is called as the complete joint penetration. Whenever there are two metals are touching each other, it makes partial joint connection, which is called as a PJP joint. Let's review some questions. Question number 1. Who decides the type of weld and weld joint needed in the joint design? A. Fabricator. B. Design engineer. C. Inspector. D. Welder or welding personnel. Question number 2. What type of joint is shown in the figure? A. Lap joint. B. Corner joint. C. T joint. D. Butt joint. What type of joint is shown in the figure? A. Lap joint. B. Corner joint. C. T joint. D. Butt joint.